Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to TechGig webinar series, our endeavor to empower techies. We believe that sharing of knowledge is the key to enhance our skills and grow us as professionals. With this principle in mind, we have initiated a series of webinars conducted by industry experts to give you all a crisp insight of various domains. The topic of today's session is crowd testing, and it is the 29th session for software testing series. Our guest speaker today is Rupesh Garg, Senior Manager, Wipro. Rupesh is working as Senior Manager with Test Advisory Services. His areas of expertise include performance, automation, cloud-based testing solutions and innovation. Rupesh holds an MS from Oklahoma State University, USA and Bachelor's degree in Engineering. PMP and ITIL Foundation certified, he's also completed executive management programs from IIMC and Harvard University. He's passionate about spiritual sciences and social work. So without further delay, I introduce you all to our guest speaker. Over to you, Rupesh.
Hello.
We can hear you. We can hear you, Rupesh, now. Rupesh? You there? Yeah, we can hear you, Rupesh.
Okay, thank God. Okay, that's
there. Can you hear me? Please. Yeah, please. Yeah, we can hear you. Please start the webinar now.
Okay, excellent, marvelous. I think anyhow we are late for 14 minutes, but drop the session today. So welcome on board, everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, from wherever you're taking this call. This is Rupesh Kurt. Let me give a brief introduction about myself first. I think I work with Wipro Technologies as a senior manager. I work with a group named as a test advisory services inside Wipro testing services. So our job is to define the next 10 QA journeys for any kind of customers in the testing landscape. So we have been working with the large and small customers in multiple geographies to define the initial strategies. So that has been our outlook as of now, and right now I'm in front of you, to present on the cloud testing gesture. So eventually, a couple of months back, we were doing this research on the cloud testing topic, especially on the cloud testing also. So this topic came to me, and I found it interesting that, you know, this is a game and guns. So that's how we have picked up this topic. It's very, very interesting topic. A lot of new research has been done into the landscape, so we find quite a bit of new research coming up over there. So let's first of all, I think we can have to understand what is the, you know, crowdsourcing, right? What is the agenda of today's discussion? Number one, crowdsourcing, what is the definition of it? Evolution of crowdsourcing, how the crowdsourcing has evolved over the time, crowd testing, the process view, what motivates the crowd, crowdsourcing examples, and also we have to just look on the norm. Cloud testing examples also, all right? So let's get to the next one. So you can obviously see Wikipedia definition. The Wikipedia definition of it is that an act of outsourcing technique into which you are eventually not you know, owning the penalty, basically. Let me read by the line. The act of outsourcing task is eventually performed by an employee or a contractor to an unidentified large group of people or committee accounts to an open school. So that is how Wikipedia defines the definition of crowdsourcing. So now there is an interesting book written by one guy called Jack Cole. If you get access to it, in fact I have a paper copy of that one. He wrote this book, you know, called The Rise of Crowdsourcing in 2006. I think it was 2008. So he defines a distributed labor method are using the internet to exploit the sheer processing power of millions of human beings. First example, Wikipedia. Any end achieved by harnessing the wisdom and labor of the crowd. Another definition we have given, any and achieved by harnessing the wisdom and labor of sound. So what does it mean? You are looking also not only to pure, you know, pure effort perspective, but we are looking onto wisdom angle also, right? Because you might not be able to improve very quickly in your automation, that is true with every automation. So I'm sure you will agree with this, number one. Number two, you will find that, you know, many wiser people might not be willing to be part of any organization full time. They can always be consultants, and they can always be, you know, looked up to for advice, but not for any actual work on the ground, right? So yeah, we have plenty for younger folks to do the job on the ground. So that has been our strategy, right? Okay, I got to be more louder, Okay, I'm trying to be more louder. So that is the definition of crowdsourcing. Now, looking at the example of another definition he gave is distributing the burden of the large endeavor. So any larger project which is not possible to be done, you might remember even in thousands of years back in Indian history also, many times if a project is way too large for the king to accomplish it, he'll give it an open call. Will give an open request to the public that please help me to accomplish this job, you know, which was not possible. Right. So that way he'll make it clear to effort.
Rupesh, I just want to interrupt you. Can you please be a bit loud? Rupesh, can you please be a bit loud? A lot of people from our audience cannot hear you clearly. You just need to be a bit loud.
Okay, is it louder?
Yes, it's, this is good.
Okay, this is good. Okay, the phone is now next to my mouth. So.
Okay.
So, is it good? Just throw me, let me know whenever my volume goes down. I'll try to be as loud as possible. Okay. Now good? You're good? Doing good? Hello? Throw me. Okay, so that is a and number, why a flexible open call, the voluntarily undertaking of a task, the undertaking of a task of variable complexity and modularity, and in which the crowd should participate, bringing their work, money, knowledge and or experience, always entail mutual benefit. The user will receive the satisfaction of a given type of need, be it economical, social recognition, self-esteem or the development of an individual skill. While the crowdsourcing will obtain the and utilize to their advantage that what the user has brought to the venture. Whose form will depend on the type of activity undertaken. Right. So eventually whole paradigm is that you are leveraging onto the wisdom of the crowd, you are leveraging onto open knowledge and open mind of the industry. Some of you might be aware that few years back, Google had requested that they want to use the free processing powers of your laptop, of your desktop. I'm not sure how many of you are aware about that phenomena, in which they came like with a crowdsourcing kind of example. They said, we want to, you know, we want to install a small software in your machine. We want to use the processing power of your processor. When you are not using it in night or in the daytime, whenever your machine is on, but you are already using it, through internet we want to, you know, virtually access your machine and then use the processing power. And, you know, many people like me also cooperated with me, we helped them, right? We helped them to get free access to our processing power. So now that was a, you know, machine processing power. Then there's another brain processing power. You know, somebody says, what is the best idea to do it, right? So you go out to the market and figure it out from people, like Rupee Design. Right, in India, rookie design has been done through what? Government didn't design. Right, one guy, I think in IIT Delhi, he designed it, right, rookie. And then what government did? They gave a super act for that guy and, you know, gave him the congratulations and gave him the money also, right? Apart from money, I think more is a sense of satisfaction for the person who has won the prize, right? There was a meritage for different movies also, in Hindi movies also, they have come up with a very good contest. Right? One movie of Kareena Kapoor and Shahid Kapoor, which is the king of the contest, that anybody who can give a better name than this one will give the money. And also some role in the movie. So, people did it, so they want to do it, right? So, but I think the movie's name didn't change, so eventually things they didn't like any suggestions which came back to them. Similarly, I think, maybe Hyundai examples, right? Hyundai has a child who was giving an ad that, how should I pay my left side? Who will help me? So whosoever will help me, they will, get to see some ad with the Shah Rukh Khan and also will get more benefits from the company also. So, right, that's a real life example of crowdsourcing, right? Mm-hmm. Like that. So, definition, I give you some interesting examples. I'm hoping it's definitely interesting the required level of interest which is needed in the audience. Right. Rohini, I'm just doing a check with you. Am I good? Mohini? Okay. I'm hoping my voice is audible to the audience. So let's look at next one, crowdsourcing. What is the definition? This is the next generation of search. It's a kind of a collaborative brain of searchable database of everything everyone knows. It's a culture of generosity. The fundamental belief is everyone knows something. So eventually, it's like Yahoo Research defines it, generous act of helping out other people. When I was planning to go for MBA, I never went for MBA school. They were like, I read in the, when I was reading about most of the year schools, they were one of the Stanford schools, they were telling. So the concept is not to promote aggressive competition between individual to individual, but between teams. Because eventually you are competing, right? So, the whole concept is we are working between teams. So you should be able to work between teams. Eventually, what is the concept of working with people? Take help from each other, be generous to each other, right? In giving the ideas, giving information. Right? So that is what they are saying. It's a culture of generosity, if you read it to that particular point, right? So a larger community of points, right? Now, it's a collective knowledge, right? Now looking at the evolution of crowdsourcing. This I found very interesting research in which they have defined the steps into which crowdsourcing is being done. First, if you look 20 years back, 30 years back, how the majorly the IT industry was insourcing. Work was done within that organization. No chargeback or financial. There's nothing like charging back from one department to another department, that concept was not even there. Right? Then traditional approach was there. Vertical structures were there. There is no metric structures concept. There is only department-driven structure over there. Then outsourcing came. They said get work done with outside the other professional. Provide the paid for services. Technology outsourcing started in the early 90s. Even before that, manufacturing, especially in the US, started very highly. If you look at 70s, 80s, when General Motors and Ford for the case in the US market, it came with a lot of competition over there, right? Then came open sourcing. You must have heard in the year of 2000, a lot of open sourcing came, and they were one of the most popular, lockers of the industry to the world between the fight between Mozilla and Microsoft. Into which judge gave evidence that even they can break up Microsoft because the Microsoft intention was to abolish any company which is trying to create a competition for them, right? So open sourcing become a big thing in the 2000 kind of decade of 2000 years, right? Product available for free distribution and use, right? Licensing, subscription, they say technology open sourcing started in the 90s, right? So that seems practical. Now the next thing is, so coming up in the mid-90s, 2000 days, crowdsourcing. So even if you look at the book written by him, how he also wrote it in 2006, right? Idea source online, glorified organization. Innovator rewarded for contribution. Right? So these are the main things which we did, right? Over there. So I hope there is another very interesting statement I found for somebody. Large groups of people are smarter than a light few, no matter how brilliant. So, you know, here the guy is trying to say, make a point that, you know, seek out help from larger and larger group of people. It will definitely help you much faster. Right? That's the point of this. Now, let's go to the next one. I found this as an amazingly beautiful slide, this number of account. It is again emphasizing that teamwork is the best one. People are excited. People are finding it fun to start a business. What are the key benefits? Key benefits are costs are contained. Number two, reduced time to market is there. More innovative solutions are there. More hands to get the job done at the time of need. Right? If you have 1,000 people, even if they are ready to contribute 1 hour, even if they are much better than 20 number team, which is contra, you know, full-time dedicated to you, because they will be only able to put 20 hours at the time. Shorter time to cycle, multiple languages testing, very easy to get it done. Testing and support the social platforms and languages due to wide variety of audience from multiple technology and language testing. So this is one of the biggest benefits, even Facebook is doing, right? So they get their testing done from the crowdsourcing environment. Because see, when you're, you know, like if you're issuing your website or your software in multiple languages, right, you cannot hire so many people who know so many languages, who are proficient in languages, who understand the nitty-gritties of so many world languages, right? You can might be able to create the software. So what do you do? The best thing is take the help of the crowd. You know, hook up to the competition and then see how we can tap it on. Right? So that is one of the best ways of accessing that thing. Right? So we got to be, it's very, very beneficial. Right? So I'm hoping the volume is good. I'm continuing. Let's go to the next one. What motivates the crowd? What really makes people contribute? I am initiating a crowd testing or a crowd competition because I know the benefits. I am a movie director. I want to name of the movie. I'm trying to make a new design of my software. I want ideas to come from people. But why people would like to contribute? So let's see what the founder of Linux is saying. He says passion to do something. Most good programmers who programming not because they expect to get paid or get adulation by the public, but because it is fun to program. Just to find it so much satisfying internally to program it, like it. Number two, recognition. Obviously, you would like to be a hero among people. Number three, opportunity. Building a network is important for anyone's growth. Right. I will be talking about in detail about in one of the lectures that why building a network is very important for any business leader, any kind of guy. Why it's so important, right? It's very important. So then financial gain also. Many companies, in fact, I have been seeing many ads from General Motors or Chevy in India also. That they're giving many awards for like cars and other stuff. Car companies are also launching many awards and things, right? So that is what they do. So this is the one thing. Now, crowdsourcing examples. New logo for the rupee, I told you, right? New logo for the rupee was designed by Indian public with cash rewards. Pepsi launched a market campaign in early 2007, which allowed consumers to design the look of a Pepsi can. The winners would receive a prize of $10,000 and the artwork would be featured on 500 million, my God. I don't know how much, 50 billion Pepsi cans are on the United States. So many Pepsi cans, right? Crowd, originally founded in 2009, is an online work platform that breaks work into realized project workflows and makes individual tasks available to crowdsourcing. So this is also another example, very, very important one, where it will help you to understand. I'm stopping on the slide for a minute for you to read through it and digest the complete thing. Okay, I hope everybody has read through this slide. So let's put next one. Amazon Mechanical Turk. It was a very, very new concept launched by Amazon 2005. A platform which crowdsourcing tasks called HIP can be created and publicized and people can execute the task and be paid for the resource. Dubbed as artificial intelligence, it was named after a 18th century chess game machine. So we'll see details of this once also in the coming slide. Award design platform. Spanish crowdsourcing platform launched in 2011. More than 2,000 designers, writers from over 15 countries, Spain and Latin America, help entrepreneurs, startups, and small businesses with logo design, web design, illustration, and other types of graphic design. That if you have to get this kind of work done in India, very expensive. Number one is there is no community to help people. Number two, even a territory community, they are the site will be so active like that, I mean 15 countries like that. Right. Netflix site has an open competition for the best collaborative filmmaking algorithm that predicts user ratings for films based on previous ratings. The competition was held by Netflix and online DVD rental service and was completed in September 2009. The grand prize of $1 million was reserved for the entry which best shows Netflix's own algorithm for predicting ratings for episodes. So if you feel something is very complex and you don't want to do it, it can be a art of design, it can be a mathematical algorithm, it can be, you know, work, producing some work in a very short span of time, how will it help you? And it has been already delivering a lot of value. Ideas on help Dell to finalize its strategy for the Linux market. So going ahead with Ubuntu Linux on select machines. You might have already heard about it. What is Ubuntu machine? All Ubuntu machines are, have been, you know, quite bit, have been, have a penetration in the market in the last couple of years. Unique Identification Authority of India invited public to design its logo. Again, it's no idea. I told first about rupee, right? Now you say first you saw rupee. Now you're seeing example about textile also. Right? So I'm talking over here. 30 seconds, so that you can have a complete look at the site. Okay, next one. Facebook. Facebook has just crowdsourcing, like I was telling before, since 2008 to create different lengthy versions of its site. The company claims this method offers advantage of providing site versions that are more compatible with the local culture. freelancer.com. Started out in Sweden in 2004 at getafreelancer.com. Owned by Sydney, Australia-based Mission Networks. I'm Barry, the CEO of Claim, the company's largest outsourcing site in the world, with CV more global traffic than competitor alliance. The site has 1.5 million users in 234 countries. And every got batch job size is less than $200. It projects a $50 million revenue in over the next 12 months. The site takes it and some cut on the workload element. Very good, right? You're getting work over there. And you know, you can vouch for the job. Like there, similar example was done in the US market called as H1B jobs.com. So you know, 7-8, I think about 10 years back, it was very popular on the US. So what they were saying is, you know, if you want to find a job, just go to H1B jobs.com. They will help you to transfer your H1B. They will not take any money because you have to find your own project. The moment you find your own project, that's it. You settle with the project and they will manage your H1B. So that was a very unique thing they were doing. So anyhow, now let's go to Unilever. Those outsourcing to Spicer, a premise TV ad. New giant drops ad agency law after 16 years and puts a $10,000 price for creative marketing ideas. See, and you know, many companies are dropping the marketing agencies or at least no, reducing the dependency on them, keeping in mind that, you know, they have other options like giving TV ads and all. So some of the companies in the crowdsourcing industry are like More for Hire. This organization is focused on testing mobile devices. Site gives allows a way to match developers and freelancers. Developers listen and describe their project that they need tested. You know, that's quite popular. Another one is Top Coder. Top Coder's strategy is to use competition to entice the designers, developers, and testers to create solutions for the client. The competition covers a full gamut of software development process from requirement specification to deployment. Then there is one more company in the testing landscape, UTest. UTest currently has a community of over 20,000 testers that get paid on a per month basis. Clients specify the type of tests that they need to have performed and the types of devices that must be tested. So in fact, you know, I'll spend maybe next, if possible in the next lecture, more time in the UTest company also. So you will get to understand quite a bit that how this such a small company has gone so high in the industry. And they are one of the best examples in the competition. Right. 99test.com team came together in September and launched on 14th of November 2010. This is a company that has been launched in India with Indian-based company. Very interesting. They are also trying to extend the crowd testing in the Indian world. So that are the some of the examples. I think I'll stop on this slide for a minute so that you can understand and digest the concept out of it. Right. Let's go to the next one. Am I audible? Is it going good, Rohini? I'm just typing down to you. Okay. So the next one is success story. Which is talking about, like, you know, TED. I don't know if you have heard about TED or not, but TED is one of the like rages in the US industry and especially in other countries also have been. They're so popular that, you know, people are desperate to seek at the TED conferences. Because somebody started an idea that, you know, you want to share something, come in the TED platform, share something like any kind of idea. So, you know, initially they were audience coming in hand. As they started moving in a particular direction, they found they have tons of support coming from different people onto this direction. And they are finding that, you know, there are tons and tons of people who are, you know, launching for this this point that, you know, how they want to share the idea, right? So, in fact, in India also it has been quite hit that as of November 19, 2010, you see 4,190 volunteers, 79 languages, 1 to 8 months subtitles, right? So if somebody is speaking on TED, now it's considered to be like a matter of prestige. Like somebody spoke on Microsoft conference, it's like that. they are kind of making it so popular that you know people are make you know people are desperate to speak at them. And very very large speakers of large size you know come down there and speak on different ideas. It's beautiful. Even if you go to their website, you'll find they're talking a lot of new ideas. And nobody else has told me like that. So definitely, you know, it will be something nice to see. So that is like one of the typical examples of the processing. Text tools, a good plan is to include a statement of your class images, you know, like we are giving examples over here. People are helping with the transcription to other people also. UniversalSubtitles.com, there is another website which is operating, 3095 video captions, download in various caption formats including .srd for the uploading to YouTube or embed to YouTube share on any webpage with the captions, uploading captions to YouTube. Fixtheweb.net, this is also another example, you know, basically much cheaper. Hey, eventually, right, why somebody will come to any kind of website for the processing because they find it's more warranty driven, it's more cheaper, it's much higher quality, right? So that's how it is. You know, G-Funky, Firefox extension that allows users to run scripts and that modify HTML web pages content every time it pages, right? We have a web page for that one. Crowdsourcing. So I'll take you now to next one. Crowdflower. This is also another commercial. Many people are opening crowdsourcing companies like a website. They are operating like a commercial initiative. They are paying the people who are working, operating over there on the website. Like there is one, like another website called angiesmith.com in here. Very, very popular. You know, it has been, people are using the service. Somebody is managing the website in an official way. And there was another list, there was something called fakesmith.com. I don't know how many of you heard. It has been super hit. Because that is where it started off. You have something to sell, you want to share on the website. You have something to buy, you share on the website. You want to rent out your flat, you give it out. You want to buy out your flat, you give it out. You know, all that kind of stuff. So pure play crowdsourcing example. So same thing Crowdflower has done. They are in even last line if you look, they are saying quality control measures. They have brought something like that also, right? So here it is labor on demand, here is the outer interface of the website. Crowdflower makes it easy for the company to tap thousands of workers for short stretches and yet get good quality work. So one of the constraints, you know, people say that, you know, crowdsourcing might be a good way of getting cheaper work done, but not a high quality. So now what people are doing even is that they are sharing the, you know, statistics for the two people. Like if you look at it, you know, ensuring job statistics. If I'm like Rupesh, I have done certain jobs on the website, they will give a, you know, you consumer feedback over there. They work really about, you know, they will tell how many jobs you have done in the last 1 year, 1 week, 2 weeks. Everything they give you, to give a sense of confidence that, you know, this is not any fake website. Nobody, you know, hunky dory can, you know, jump over there and, you know, kind of do anything. Right? Gold standard, ensure quality prevents scammers from giving the bad results. Interface to, so these are some of the, you know, improves, helps in two ways, improves personal efficiency, cloud to determine who is doing that product. So another, now this is one of the important ones which I want to see. You must have already used it, half of it, at least encyclopedia, I can say, everybody in the world has used it, right, with confidence. But some of the other things you might not have used it, like Yahoo, some of you have, I've used it very few times. There's a site called Baidu.com in China, which is very popular. There's a Facebook, I told already, has been using crowdsourcing for the languages. Same thing is true with the Twitter, LinkedIn also, and with the Google also. Google also also another innovative into which they are venturing to make payment. You know, ask me a question and get paid for your, and you know, set your price and get your answer. So like, let's say you have an exam for a question, you say I'll pay $1 for it. Somebody want to do it, give an answer, you'll give. Otherwise, no, it will remain open. So you know, it's like, you know, open bidding in the market, you bid for it and you get an answer. And then there is something like Taskcon, and then there is MSN.com and Windows 5 also, right? So it sounds like Microsoft is also picking up with the crowdsourcing world. So I'll show you some other sites also. Like Yahoo MC launched in December 2005, 60 million users and 65 million answers as of December 2006. Live question and answer, right? And Wikipedia. Incentives like selling, monetary is your incentive. Non-monetary is social gratification and publicity. Reputation points, certification levels. Like, many of them say, you've seen LinkedIn, people will try to get their answer 5 stars. People would like to see that, on their profile that my answer has been treated top 10 answers in LinkedIn. That kind of stuff. So, incentives for both participation and quality. Now, coming to platform, 1.7 million users. So I'm telling about one more site, where you saw platform, Chinese site I remember. Let's look at them also. 1.7 million digital users. Definitely they must less than Java also, but still a good amount of competition from one country angle. In less than 2 years, request to solution for nearly 3,100 tasks and 540 CK solutions have been produced. More than 5 lakh people responded. A user offers a monetary award for a question or task another user provides solution to complete the reward. Right. I mean, they, you ask, you have a question, you, somebody will help you by getting money. The website plays the role of a third party by collecting the money from the person distributing the award to the winner who is decided by the recipient. Website takes a small portion of the award as a subsidy. That's very fair because somebody's money is website, your own team or a company working in the background. Socially stable, a core group of users who repeatedly propose and win. Incentive-wise mechanism, potential monetary and then purchase people's participation. It is definitely not like a Wikipedia, which encourages all free contribution, but here it is, you have a problem, somebody's helping you, but you're getting paid for it. But still, that concept also works, which was a pure crowdsourcing, this also works. On interface, it's a Chinese website. Incentives, they are giving some stats about their website also. Another interface for the platform. Now, Yahoo Answers. So Yahoo Answers, you see, it's selling, right? You earn certain points in the Yahoo Answers, right? There is points to send you. So here, some other statistical data we had collected. I don't think we need to get into it today. Some important statistics about Yahoo Answers, more than 21 million users in the US, 9 million users worldwide, largest knowledge sharing community on the web. Anyone can ask and answer questions on any topic, connecting people to information, they are speaking with people who know it, providing a way for people to share their experience and insight. All of now, again, interface of Yahoo Answers, I can see it. This is a very interesting one. We collected a data that it shows that, what is the length of a thread. If you ask me a question on the programming, people might have, hardly a couple of replies coming back and forth. If you have a question on marriage, the length of thread is quite high. In case of wrestling, means in case you get into fight with somebody, then it becomes much longer also. Right? So these are some of the examples. These are my references. Let's do a small recap of some of the important companies I wanted to get you guys into your brain. Very important one. See this one, online encyclopedia. Nobody can deny it's a crowdsourcing. It's obviously contribution of so many people across the world. Then you have Yahoo Answers, which is another successful. Then you have Baidu.com and you have Google Answers. You have LinkedIn, who are testing the software in multiple languages. You have Twitter, you have Facebook, you have Fastcon, you have quite a bit of companies, right, who are doing testing, development, contribution in certain ways on the, on the website. So these are some of the examples I wanted to help you guys to understand what is cloud testing and get an overall about the viewpoint focus and how cloud testing is playing a role. Let's go to the initial part of the slide again to get a little bit of a better idea. I think this slide should be Good. We should revise it again. First of all, we saw in the industry from the outsourcing IT industry angle, then we saw outsourcing, then we saw open sourcing, then we saw crowdsourcing. So these are the, you know, major things we saw in the industry which was shifting up. So very, very important is that keep it in the mind, you know, to help you quite a bit, right? So that's all from my side, from the crowdsourcing angle and crowdsourcing angle. If audience feels, you know, if you want one more lecture on the crowd testing also, we can definitely do it. In fact, I tried to cover a bit of crowd testing in this one. But, you know, we can always talk more detail about few companies who are doing it very, very specifically in this. So, Rohini, I think I'm done. We can open the platform for the session. Rohini, hello, are you there? Hello, Rohini. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Rupesh, we've already started assigning you some questions, so I hope you can see them.
Okay, just one minute.
Yes, we've already given you some of the questions.
Okay, I got it. So one question is from Shirin Mawaslu, I am. The problem is with the crowdsourcing is need to do a lot of cleaning work as they report duplicate issues, which consumes a lot of time to focus. How to manage this? Okay, very good. The question I repeat again is, the problem with the crowdsourcing is need to do a lot of cleaning work as they report the ticket issues, which consumes a lot of time to focus, how to manage them. Okay, very good. So, see, number one, like I was telling about this company, Crowdflower, right? They are doing it, they are doing a rating. They are doing a particular rating to each worker. What is the quality of work being given to them? It's the same example. See, if you have an electrician coming to your house, you don't have any defined framework to rate an electrician, but based on your experience with them, you will define them. Number one. Number two, your payment will be back to them. Like you test is a small company in the testing. What they do is they tell you, so you pay us not based on how much, you know, how many bucks you have, but you pay us based on, you know, based on what kind of, if you're accepting a defect, you pay us per defect, right? Acceptable defects for a customer, then only you pay us. Not that any kind of defects we can keep on raising day and night, you can keep us paying them. Does that help you? I hope that helps with the answer. Number two, how do we implement crowd testing while implementing a live project deployment? Venkatesh Vasu. Yeah, very, very valid question. Implementing crowd testing in a customer example might not be too very valid or very, it is a difficult affair. Especially keeping in mind that, you know, you will not be doing it, you cannot implement this kind of scenarios everywhere. It's like, you know, every company is very, you know, very much serious or very much insecure about their security system. So you might perceive that, you know, they might not be, they might be viewing it as a security threat. But a lot of companies are opening up, you know, one of the major factors is agility the crowd gives you. Like I give an example, you need 2,000 people to test in the next 2 hours. Can you get to full-time employee basis? No. Can you get to your, you know, to your smaller base of people? Yeah, obviously you can get. Right. So that is, you know, crowdsourcing will help you to deploy it on the ground. how do you differentiate how different crowd testing is from ABB testing? Tapan, can you type again what is the A slash B testing? Okay. I will Tapan, that kind of question, I'll hold them. Next one is, why do you think crowdsourcing has become more popular despite having very intelligent employees in the company? See, I'm the, that's a fact of life, that, if a company is carrying 1 lakh employees, they would have only 20% increase, right? Rest of the employees are either moderate or even not any very much value for the organization. So they might not carry any kind of innovative thought process in them. They might not carry any new ideas in them. But while there is no cloud in the market, you know, a lot of people carry a lot of ideas, right ideas in the system, which are, might not be part of your organization. Right, that is our intention. Otherwise, if we want to always tap onto the potential of your company, then what is the purpose of making, these ideas like your smart, hard of giving coordination, or American society of engineers, or IEEE. You know, these kind of societies are meant to tap onto the potential of larger ecosystem, not just within your organization, but across the worldwide platform. The similar intention is to serve, is to tap onto that kind of potential. Okay. So that I will say. Tapan, if you want to repeat again your question, you're most welcome. Otherwise, I'll skip this question. Okay, that's all. I have covered up my question. Oh, okay. A lot of my questions. Somebody else is also typing. Just one minute. Tapan, after this question by... Okay, now this question by Priyanka Raji Shirke. Could you please share the slide which is differentiate between in between sourcing, outsourcing, open sourcing, evolution slide? Sure, I'll share the slide and reject it also from where I took this slide. Okay. It's actually info. Let me just take the audience to that particular slide. See, Priyanka is asking for a slide, this slide. Okay. So even if you put on Google this paper name, you'll find it automatically yourself also. And it can be openly downloaded. If you put Infosys research and you put that paper name. Now, Matagai Raj, how secure is to give your product from outage? Yeah. That's a very, very valid concern, but a lot of retail companies, like, you saw Facebook, LinkedIn, Google Live, see, a lot of things are needed to bring out to the crowd because, they have to be, they will be used for millions or millions of people across the world. You cannot get it tested by, 50, 100, 200 people offshore development. You will not be able to get that coverage of the test cases done from them. So you obviously need to hand it out to near setup. Okay. Now Sudhir here, IP-based testing project NDA, how to test it. Yeah, that is very for the NDA kind of project, there are several customers in which we also deal. They will like anybody from the other ODC to walk into their ODC. So those kind of customers are this conference will not work. So you got to try it out with the people who are more receptive, who want to save cost, and who have, who are not so much finicky about security issues. Now, next one. My question to you is, what is the difference between crowd testing and ABB testing? Okay, that is again a repeat of the question. What is the process involved in crowd testing? Is there a process that is defined and available? See, if you want to Kalpana, if your question is, what is the process in the crowd testing? See, there is no access process testing. But if you want to understand one, read a lot about the crowd testing, I request you to go to this company website. I'm taking the slide over there. Okay, this one is good. This one, U-test. And the 19-inch.com. These two sites have tons of data. You can download and now, or is it the best left to me, best to be decided by the tester? So, I told you the two companies, you should refer to, right? Okay. So now, no more questions I can see as of now on my table. Anybody has any questions, please open up and ask yourself. Any last call for the questions? Hello. Yeah. Mohini, I don't know. Seems to be done. Hello. Hello. Hello, Mohini. Hello. Kalpana, yeah, you are asking one more question, I think. In such a case, in case of crowd testing, how do you measure the reliability of the output delivered? See, that is what I told in the start also, two ways. Number one is like, I say, going to give you one example of a company called as Crowdflower, right? What they're doing is they're rating the worker, right? Anybody is registering over there to register themselves, they're rating the worker. And they're giving live example that what kind of quality work this guy has done, number one. Like LinkedIn has, if you're answering good, people, you will have a star in your profile, like a military guy, right? Quality control measures, right? Number two, you will pay it. The customer will pay it only based on the quality deliverable. If they find the document is nonsense or whatever testing we have done is nonsense, then they will not be able to do it. So that is another point in which you want to see, right? Any more questions, Mohini, are you there? Hello. Hello.
Thanks for the insightful presentation.
Hello.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks for the presentation, Rupesh. It was indeed a great session. I would also like to thank all our participants for their support in making this webinar a success. The recording of the webinar will be available on techgig.com by tomorrow. Thank you all. Thank you, Rupesh, once again.
Yeah, thank you, Mohini.